Hello Internet, and welcome to a new tutorial. So in this tutorial, we're going to talk about bell sounds and how we can use them in psytrance music, especially the darker spectrum of the psychedelic dance music like forest psytrance. Now the sound we're going to make is heavily inspired by a track from Pitron and Orestes called Pure Frequency. It was actually a request from one of you guys that asked me to replicate one of the leads. Now we're not going to make that lead, we're going to make something heavily inspired by that lead and that track, and I thought I should give credit to that. Now, before we dive into this tutorial, if you'd like to support the channel, you can consider becoming one of my patrons, buy my presets on Gumroad, or just leave a like, comment, subscribe. Things like that helps the channel a lot. Now, with that said, let's dive into this tutorial. So here we are in Bitwig, and actually I've created a loop idea for a forest track. And I've been thinking, since I've been getting more and more comments for forest-oriented tutorials, maybe I can develop this loop to become a skeleton of a track at least, and actually make a series of videos showing the steps and how I got there. So if this idea interests you and you would like to see this series of videos, please leave a comment down in the comment section. Now, before we make that bell sound, this loop sounds like this. Yeah, pretty dark, at least for me. You know, I'm like a C major happy guy that likes Twilight music. So yeah, this is a little bit dark for me. Anyways, the sound we're making today will be made using Serum. And actually, I've already created a simple pattern. It has one simple note, D2, because the track is in D. Here we have a initialized patch of Serum. Sounds like this. To make a really simple bell sound, we need a sine wave. Sounds like this. So a bell is basically a plucky sound. So we'll take off the sustain, we'll leave a little bit of decay. Now we have this. Nothing too special, give it some release. So this is a really basic bell sound, okay? Now let's make it a psychedelic bell sound, because this is what's interesting, right? What I'm going to do, I'll crank the detuning all the way up. So now we have this. Sounds like some sort of a super sine wave lead. Yeah, we don't want that. We want to make it even more psychedelic. And actually, this trick I've already showed in one of my tutorials. I'll leave a link to that in here. And we're going to use what I consider one of the most underrated sections of Serum, which is the unison section in here. So we have this range parameter. We're going to crank it all the way up and check this out. We got this. Okay, we're already getting some sort of a like kind of melting sound, if that makes sense. Like there's way too much detuning going on. So if I'll play the pattern, we have this. Perfect. So what I'm going to do, I'll add a filter in here. I'll set it to a bandpass filter, just like so. And crank the resonance, give it some drive. Now we have this. Okay, pretty cool. I'll take this envelope in here and make it open the filter like just a tiny bit and really, really, really quick. Now I have this. Actually, what I'll do, I'll take off the envelope in here. I'll use a little LFO. Set it to something fast. Now we have this. Yeah, actually, instead of like open it, we'll just give it some sort of a wiggle. Pretty cool. And what we'll do also is modulate the fine pitch of this sine wave. So I'll just use the second LFO, set it to trigger. I'll leave it on 104. Now we have this. Now we need some sort of a reverb. And for this, I want to use the Valhalla Supermassive for several reasons. First off, it has amazing algorithms. And second of all, it is free, so everyone can get it. So what we'll do in here, I'll set it to the Lyra algorithm, okay? And I'll set the delay in here to dotted, and I'll set it to 1/8, okay? So now we have this. Nothing too special for now. I'll take the feedback a little bit down, and I'll give it some warping. Now we have this. So we got this, some sort of a kind of a glitchy delay thing. Pretty cool. Give it more density. I'll take the mod in here. I'll set it to 100%, and I'll give it some moderate. Now we have this. Okay, pretty cool. Give it more density. And a little bit more mix. Okay, pretty cool. So it's still not that psychedelic, right? Let's make it even more. So I'll go back to Serum. I'll go to the effects section here. I'll set the second filter on. And I'll set it to a comp filter. I'll close the cutoff a little bit and give it some resonance, some drive. Now we have this. To make it even more psychedelic, I'll use a pitch shifter. Now, most DAWs, as far as I know, has a pitch shifter, so that shouldn't be a problem for most of you. We'll play with the pitch shifting in here. So we'll just automate it. Pretty simple. So set it here, and I'll take it one octave higher, just like so. So now we have this. Pretty cool. I'll take the grain down, and we can take them up. Doesn't really matter. What matters is, does it sound right for you? For me, it sounds right like so for now. Also, I'll change this filter to a Moog 24 decibel per octave, like so. And actually, I'll make this wiggle to maybe 132. Let's see what we have. I'll leave it to bandpass 24 decibel per octave, but with a faster LFO. Okay, pretty cool. And the last thing that I'm going to do, I'll use a delay plus in here. I'll leave it the way it is. Give it just a little bit of feedback. Now we have this. And now with the kick and bass, check what we already have. Now, one of the things that I really love about Bitwig is that we can actually right-click on the button here and set bounce in place. So what it'll do is render out the output of the synthesizer without rendering the effects with it. So this is basically the raw sound that we have. I'll take this sample and I'll pitch it one octave lower. And I'll set the stretching algorithm to slice. Now we have this. Maybe play with the format a little bit, set it to, let's say, 12. Pretty cool, right? Now with the kick and bass, we have this. We can also automate the pitch in here, so maybe I'll take it an octave higher, and let's see what we have. So yeah, this is the weird psychedelic bell sound I was talking about. I know it has nothing to do with a bell, but that's the whole point of it. It was inspired by a bell sound. And then I thought to myself, okay, let's try to develop the sound even further and make something new out of it. And for me, this is the whole point of me making these tutorials. So yeah, I hope that makes sense. And yeah, actually, if you want to push this sound even further, I highly suggest that you use Vital, because in the advanced mode in here, you have the tuning range, just like in Serum, and you can actually stack these unison sounds differently than in Serum. And you can also play with the unison detuning power, and you set it to 100%, you can play with it, and all of this will change the sound and the character of, you know, your main sound and the oscillator, how it's acting. So I will stop here for this tutorial, but I would really love to see what you will make out of this tutorial and how you will use Vital for this one. So yeah, please tag me on Instagram. There's a link for that in the description. And yeah, with this is the end of this tutorial. I really hope you've liked it. I really hope you've learned something new. And yeah, have a great one.